Have you heard that you can only absorb 30 grams of protein in one meal? Well, it's an out-and-out myth. You will absorb every gram of protein that you consume, no matter if it's 10 or 100 grams. You may not use it to build muscle tissue, but you don't just consume protein to build lean tissue. You use it for your immune function. Every organ in your body needs it. And if they don't, you're going to use it as a fuel source. So, myth dispelled. You use every single gram of protein that you consume. But where does it come from? Well, it's a relation to building muscle tissue. And to understand where it's come from, you have to understand what muscle protein synthesis is, or MPS. MPS is the process in which your body builds and repairs muscle tissue. How do we stimulate MPS? Training and consuming protein. In studies, we will see that consuming a higher amount of protein, so 60 or 80 grams, doesn't further stimulate muscle protein synthesis compared to consuming 30 grams. So there's a little bit of a truth in there, a little bit, but it comes with its own caveats. This 20 or 30 gram limit, it really depends on each individual. It depends on your age, it depends on your sex, it depends on your weight, it depends on your training style. It could be 20 grams, it could be 40 grams. And the other caveat is, we know for a fact that you're going to maximally stimulate muscle protein synthesis and gain as much muscle tissue as possible, consuming about 2 grams of protein per kilo of lean body weight. Now, if you take this at face value and only consume 20 grams in each meal, you would have to have 10 meals a day to get 200 grams, and that is not realistic. So we still need to be hitting our daily recommended protein intake. What we can take from this is that, where possible, you should not be trying to consume all of your protein in one meal or in two meals. You have a few opportunities throughout the day where you can stimulate muscle protein synthesis. So evenly distributing your meals between 3 and 5 meals a day, evenly distributing the protein, is going to be ideal to maximally stimulate muscle protein synthesis and growing lean tissue. Why is it 3 to 5 meals? Well, that's what most people eat per day. But also, when you consume protein and spike muscle protein synthesis, you get a muscle full effect. As we said there, about 30 grams, 40 grams per meal, you get a muscle full effect. Any more protein than that isn't doing a whole pile for building lean tissue, any more than the 20 to 30 to 40 grams. So once you get that muscle full effect, there's something called a refractory period. And that means that consuming any more protein there within that window isn't actually helping any more in building lean tissue. So that refractory period is about 2 to 3 hours. So when you consume the food, half an hour to an hour to start digesting it, you got a muscle full effect. Then you got a refractory period where any more protein doesn't really do a whole lot. And then it comes up again. So you've got a couple of opportunities throughout the day where you can maximally stimulate muscle protein synthesis. What I would say is, if you have a day that you're super low in protein, and let's say your goal is 150 grams, it's 8 p.m. and you realize you've only had 50 grams, you can absolutely have the 100 grams at 7 or 8 p.m., no problem. And that's something that I would do. If you don't, it's not the end of the world. It's only a drop of water in the grand scheme of things. If your goal is to maximally accrue and gain lean muscle tissue, I would be looking to consume 3 to 5 meals per day to maximally stimulate muscle protein synthesis and get the most out of the training that you're doing. If gaining lean muscle tissue is important, but it's not the most important thing in the world for you, don't be overly fixated on it. Think about your daily protein target, trying to reach that between your 2 to 4 meals, whatever fits well for the day, and that'll do perfectly fine. Any questions or queries on this, please do drop me a message. Myth busted. See you in the next one.